for this car to warm up. First of all, good morning, y'all. Welcome to the vlog. Usually, as a truck driver, you're waking up in one of these. But I'm lucky enough to where I can go to work and come home every day. 5:30 is usually like, that's kind of late. Usually we're getting up somewhere around 4:30. So 5:30, that's a blessing, yo. Yeah, man, I'll see y'all at the truck yard. We have arrived. We gotta get in the truck, start her up, and warm it up. Pressure to build up. We need to go around the truck and check the tires, make sure everything's straight and in order. Just give them a little kick. Nothing too crazy. You could break your toe on these. Forget about it. My toes are gone. I'm gonna see y'all in a second at the location where we get loaded. This is the job location. It's a water treatment facility in Hartford. Here, I think they're building a tunnel. They're like digging up a whole bunch of dirt and for like water pipes or something like that. I don't know. I just do what they tell me. We've got a loader guy. I'm gonna show y'all what that looks like in a second. And he's basically gonna take the dirt that they put in whatever pile and then load it onto us. We take it from point A to point B, and that's pretty much the entire job. Put in the simplest terms possible. I'm not sure how well y'all can see that, but that right there is what it looks like to get loaded. And that will be me next.
There it is, ladies and gentlemen. There it is.
We are out. We turn on the tag axle, the engine brake.
BSM 03 on the scale. Warning.
You're all set.
Thank you.
You basically just had to weigh in right there at a certain location. Then we're gonna head to the drop-off location, and I will see y'all there. All right, so boom, about to dump. Turn on the power for the back, that's the body. Open the tailgate with this, pull it up, lift this off. Step outside and show y'all. Alright, now with the body up in the air, you want to put it in drive, move up just a little bit. Usually I let the tailgate slam, but we have this vibrator, very sophisticated. Don't mind that. You gotta do what you gotta do sometimes, you know what I mean? Now you just put the body down. And that's pretty much it, man. I mean, it's just back and forth from there. Go, you get loaded, you weigh in, you dump. Like I said, it's just like Uber driving, but just like on a grand scale. We have made it to the last load, sixth load. I just got weighed in, got my paperwork. Now I'm about to head home. Boom, just like that. I hope y'all like that transition. I'm coming at y'all. Let's see, I recorded that on
Tuesday?
Today's Friday, so that should tell you how much time is available to me. If you have a family, if you're looking to become an owner-operator, let's just say that you won't have that much time on your hands. But I wrote down a few topics here to discuss with y'all. So we have the question of, do I enjoy my job? Yeah, I do. I think it's more so a fact that I just don't hate my job. But it's not like, it's like, whoa, the best job in the world, you know what I mean? Like, it's just, it's kind of like, you know what I mean? It's like, I don't love it, I don't hate it. So, there's a lot of things that I find that people who are impatient wouldn't enjoy about the job. So if you're an impatient person, or if you don't like to put up with a lot of bull, because you're gonna be putting up with a lot of shit in trucking. It's definitely better than Enterprise. Rent a car. I had to clean cars there I worked there for almost a year, and every day I woke up, I hated every single moment. All right, question number two. I'm sure y'all all are worried about how much money is made from trucking. Me personally, I make $20 an hour, 40 hours a week on a typical, normal, average work week. Not bad for my age. If you have a family, you know, obviously it's gonna apply differently to everybody. For the position I am right now in life, 19, going on 20, I don't have many expenses. I don't have many kids. I don't have any kids. What am I saying? Obviously, other jobs do pay more. Other jobs do pay less. There are not many huge dump trucking companies. So if you're looking into this specific niche, then a lot of people start off with a smaller company. Especially if you're younger, because I think it's easier to get hired at a younger age. But yeah, I would obviously look, if you're young or if you're older, into all areas and all facets, because you can find a good opportunity in any niche, whether it may be over the road or anything like that. Next question. How did I obtain my CDL? Now, I went to a trucking school called Affordable CDL. This is a school in Colchester, Connecticut. It is the cheapest school in Connecticut, which is why I chose it. In terms of instructors, they have quality instructors. These are people who know what they're doing and they've been in the industry for a while. So going there, I'm pretty sure in every state, you have to go through your permit test first, like your license. Then you have to go to the school. Then you have to take a class, or you can come in as a contractor, which means you don't have to take the class. At least that's how it was in that school. I believe it's a 40-hour course. I don't really remember. 30 or 40 hours in class, no driving yet. Then you go outside. Then you practice maneuvers. You have your straight back, your offset, which means you're coming in at an angle. You have your, you got to do two parallels, side-side, offside, and then you have to do your alley dock. My truck is an automatic. I have driven the manual trucks that are in the company, but I just like the automatic, I don't know. But that's gonna do it for the video. Hopefully you guys took away something from that, learned something from that. I gave you some insight in some way into how the industry works, and you got to see whether or not you want to take this as a route in your future. So if you like what you're seeing, you know what to do, and I'm out.